The city of Venice in Italy will definitely top the list of most romantic cities of the world and is a must-visit destination of Europe. Venice's innumerable wondrous waterways takes the city to the next level of beauty, which people from all over the world flock to see throughout the year. A visit to this floating city will definitely add a new spice of romance to your life. Apart from highlighting the unique experience of visiting this charming city of Venice, I will, in this video, stress upon those aspects of Venice by knowing which you too can easily visit this charming floating city. Once again, welcome back to my YouTube channel, Backpacker's Notebook, the only channel which has been created to help travel enthusiasts with most authentic and real-time information so that they can plan to travel on their own without engaging tour agents and operators. And even if they opt to engage tour operators, the knowledge and idea they get from this channel will definitely help them to have good bargain from tour operators who are always there to fool you if you are not an informed traveler. I have already posted several videos related to my Europe tour. If you haven't seen them, I would request you to view them, which will definitely help you for a proper planning of Europe tour. The URL of all those videos has been provided in the description box below. Come, join me on my Venice tour. There are 177 canals in this city of 118 islands. Each island is connected to each other by bridges. There are a total of 409 bridges here. Floating on the Adriatic Sea, the city with its colorful houses are in itself architectural masterpieces. Along with it, exquisitely crafted footbridges, beautifully designed gondolas to navigate through the narrow canals, accompanied by music of a violinist at times, makes this such an immense attraction that one will hardly be able to resist himself from coming back to this place time and again. Settlements started in Venice at the fag end of 7th century after the decline of Roman Empire. Common people, in order to escape Germanic invasions, fled from the mainland to the small islands in the Lagoon of Venice, as these places were difficult to reach and easy to defend. During the centuries, the Republic of Venice has dominated the trade routes on the Mediterranean Sea from Asia to Africa and became a place of rich merchants. I, like many others, first got introduced to the name of the city of Venice through the Shakespeare novel Merchant of Venice. Then the scene from the famous Bollywood Hindi movie Great Gambler, where superstar Amitabh Bachchan was seen floating in a gondola with his love consort in the movie Zinataman, in the famous song Dolab Zoki Hai Dil Ki Ye Kahani, is still vivid in the memory of most Indians. In order to soak in the beauty of this romantic city, I, along with my wife and son, arrived at the Venezia Santa Lucia station in Venice from Switzerland at around 1 p.m. From outside the station, we boarded the ferry service called Vaporetti to reach the San Zaccaria stop, from where our pre-booked Airbnb apartment is at a walkable distance. Venice does not have any vehicular road. Waterways and walking is the only way for moving inside the city. From the San Zaccaria stop, we used the Google map and walked through the narrow lanes of Venice to reach our apartment at about 2 p.m. Our apartment was a two-storied house, having two bedrooms in first floor, each capable of accommodating three adults, and one luxurious bathroom. In the ground floor, there was a kitchen with all necessary utensils to cook and modern cooking facilities. A dining hall with large sofa couch where one person can sleep as well, and one bathroom with bathtub. There are gymnasium apparatus and piles of books in bookshelf as well. I will definitely recommend you to book this particular Airbnb apartment in Venice. the URL of which I will provide in the description box below. After having some food, we set out for the famous central square of Venice, known as the Piazza San Marco. Google Map was our guide as usual. The distance that should take 10 minutes to reach from our apartment eventually turned out to be a distance of 40 minutes, simply because there are so many beautiful locations around every corner of the road that you will have to stop to take pictures and be mesmerized. After all, we are in Venice. The mystifying aura of romance is there in the air of the city everywhere, and you are breathing the same air. If you are loving the information provided here in this video, I will request you to please subscribe my channel and please see the entire video, as more important aspects of Venice tour is yet to come. Piazza San Marco is in the heart of Venice, which was referred to as the world's most beautiful drawing room by none other than Napoleon. This main public square contains its most famous buildings, St. Mark's Basilica and the Doge's Palace, and of course the Campanile Bell Tower. St. Mark's Basilica is an iconic symbol of Venice and one of the city's top attractions. From Monday to Saturday, it remains open for public between 9:30 a.m. to 5 p.m. However, on Sundays and holidays, it remained open between 2 p.m. to 4 p.m. We, not being much interested in religion and because of constraint of time, didn't go inside the basilica. However, this Byzantine-style basilica, being one of the most beautiful cathedrals in Europe and around the world, is worth a visit to have a taste of the intriguing combination of architectural and art styles. San Marco has the impressive Doge's Palace. Built in ancient Gothic architectural style, this building, which was once the seat of power, is now basically a museum. 98.6-meter high campanile bell tower standing tall in the central square of Piazza San Marco is another most landmark structure of Venice. Originally built to serve as lighthouse, it later transformed into a structure that was used to guide the religious space of Venetian. Magnificent view of the red roofs of the city from the top of the tower is not to be missed. But for that, you need to pre-book your tickets. I will provide the URL to book your tickets to reach the top of this campanile bell tower. When we were in the central square, a live music performance was going on in one of the shops there, with the violin playing at the center. This kind of musical concert is a common event every day in some shops or other here. Everyone around seems to be floating in the enchanting intoxication of romance that floats in the air of this city. Seeing couples from newlyweds to seniors walk hand in hand or openly kiss each other, you will understand why this city is called the City of Love. As the daylight fades out slowly and dusk fell, the entire Piazza San Marco came out with a different look. The appearance of pollution resembles the fantasy that encircles a beautiful woman. There are many small and old charming architectural palaces, museums in the alleys of the city as well. It also has a variety of boutiques, cafes and restaurants. And after every small gap, there are shops selling masks, hats or various colored glassware. You must be knowing that the city of Venice is also known as the City of Masks. Carnival is held in Venice every year. On the occasion of this carnival, masks are made with exquisite craftsmanship and artistic taste. The colorful masks of Venice are world famous. The next morning, we went to the famous Rialto Bridge, which probably is the most beautiful and famous bridge in the world. Built in the late 16th century, this stone bridge over the Grand Canal is a brilliant accomplishment of Renaissance architecture. designed by Antonio da Ponte and Antonio Contino. The exquisite craftsmanship of the bridge is a must-visit spot of Venice for travelers from all over the world. No trip to Venice is complete without a gondola or boat ride under the bridge. We also spent quite some time here enjoying the wonderful view of the canal from the top of the Rialto Bridge, and then went down and enjoyed the wonderful view of the bridge from all around. Then we hired a gondola and did a ride under the bridge and went through some of the narrow canals around. No more than 5 passengers are allowed in one gondola. A 30-minute gondola ride costs 16 euros per person, but the rate increases in night. Venice Gondola, known as the world's most romantic water boats, has successfully maintained its own characteristics and charm for ages. This particular type of boat can be seen all over Venice. A gondola ride along the city's narrow canals, appreciating the colorful buildings alongside that are silent spectators of historical events, is truly a special experience, the likes of which are second to none in the world. From the jetty next to the Rialto Bridge, we walked through the Venetian alleys to the Venezia Santa Lucia station, from where we took the train to Pisa to visit the world-famous Leaning Tower. Before entering the station came the sound of melodious music. We saw a young man with a guitar in his hand standing by the canal just outside the station, singing song, asking for help from the common people. Even though we didn't understand the words yet, we stood there fascinated by the magic of the tune. After visiting the Leaning Tower of Pisa, we returned back to our Airbnb apartment in Venice at around 11 p.m. Here, I must mention that one more day in Venice would have been ideal. I will ask you to allocate 2 entire days in Venice to have real feel of the charm of this place. In that case, on the second day, after visiting the Rialto Bridge and having your gondola ride by 12 noon, take a vaporetti and move on to visit the Murano and Burano Island. All the houses there are standing in different eye-catching colors. The small island of Murano is renowned for its long tradition of glassmaking. You can visit the glass workshop here and see the technique of making beautiful glass objects that are truly unique. Then you can move on to visit the Burano Island by boat and be mesmerized by the magic of the lace materials here. Lace of Burano has been a fashion and status symbol of Europe since its inception. By completing the tour of the above 2 small islands, move on to experience the unique charm of sunset from the golden beach of Lido Island. The island's beaches are thronged by tourists throughout the year to enjoy the incredibly beautiful sunset from here. The Venice Film Festival is held on Lido Island every year in September. The list of Hollywood and Bollywood movies that were shot in Venice is extremely long. Thus, a full 2-day tour of Venice is a must to have some feel of the romantic aura in the air of the city. But if you are on a honeymoon tour, Venice has much more in store for you in its every corner. But for that, you need to devote another day. Whether you spend 2 full days or 3 days here in Venice, the charm of the city is so indomitable that, like every other traveler, you will definitely leave the city with a promise of coming back here again. Thanks for watching the entire video. Hope it will help you to plan your Venice tour. I am sure you have subscribed my channel by now. Use the comment box for your queries. I will love to answer all your questions. Please press the like button.